Hell, there's nothing that tells me that I actually have to kill these things. All I need is the relic. That I feel like I'm not going to be able to cheat jump my way up to this time. Stairs are raised remotely. Not if I can say anything about it. I feel like I'm going to be getting another jump out of that. Oh, god damn it. Just let me zoom in. R to zoom in. Come on! Okay, fine then. I'll actually go find where the steps, where the button to release the steps are. Is this always so shiny here? Excuse me, buddy. Whoops. Thank God that door opened pretty fast. I need... Oh, okay. There was no reason, really, to look for steps then. I found the great Welkid, whatever stone. Bring it to Martin and Cloud Ruler Temple. Whoop! Whoa! Oh, not in there. Whoop, not in there. Fuck you, game. Fuck you. Fuck you. Damn it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yes! Oh my god. Now, how do I get out of here? I'm pretty sure God just... I was literally just touched by God there. And it was the greatest feeling ever. He pretty much was like... They killed him? They killed my little buddy? I honestly don't care as much as I probably should. Excuse me, zombie. Oh, hey there. Hey there, ho there. Don't touch me there. That is my no-no square. Okay. Just keep on running. Just keep on running. I can make it out of here before what's his name tries to kill me. The ruler of Icarumba. I already forgot his name. I already forgot the name of where I am. Maracana? Maracanaka? I hope to God that I'm not being followed. Oh, are you kidding me? How did I not kill everything here? I don't understand where all these enemies keep on coming from. I swear, I keep on clearing out and they just keep on respawning right back. There's like 30 corpses right here. Well, the worst part is, though, I'm gonna get out of here. I'm not gonna be able to fast travel. Like, I guarantee it. Let's see. Can I fast travel? No, I can't. What a surprise. Let's go... Whoops, that was... East, to Skingrod. Seems like the... best plan I have. Well, actually. Oh, yeah. I'm not running all the way to Cloud Runner Temple from here. Yeah, right. I figure if I get inside the limits of Skingrod, then I should be able to quick travel from there. One would think. But it wouldn't be very accurate now, would it? Whoop, jump. Just keep running. Just keep running. Run, run, run. You're acrobatic. You should rest and meditate. Yay, a level in acrobatics is my final one. That little bit faster running ability will help me so much. I'm going to run right into an Oblivion gate, aren't I? I'm going to see it right out there. She be. I can't fast travel my enemies nearby. Is something still really chasing me? That's... I just find it stunning. The tenacity of these enemies in this game is unparalleled to any other enemy ever. I feel like if these people could just coordinate a little bit better... Hello there, Daedra. Yeah, I'm not staying to talk to you. You catch up to me, then congrats. You are definitely going to slaughter me. Guaranteed. What is this? Cursed mine. Oh. Ah, now the landscape turns all red. Like, what are you doing, Wolf? Wolf is definitely not an Oblivion character. Oh, well, I'm leading this guy straight to his doom. Hey, buddy, you might want to run.
What do you want?
Run.
Let's see if we can't teach
train
you like
your character.
Too.
This character cannot help you train any higher. Shucks. Run and swim faster and regenerate less fatigue faster. It's interesting. I don't particularly think of shepherds as being the peak of physical fitness, but if they say they are, then gotta listen to Bethesda. They are Tamastors. Okay, fast travel yet, by the ways? Nope. Hey, guard, you might want to get out there. You got problems going with the Oblivion Gates and the slaughtering of townspeople. It's kind of a big deal. Now, let's say I want to get up to the castle and talk to... Oh, there we go. Castle. Yes, let's run out... actually, no, I don't. I figured if I was still being chased, I might as well go over to the castle and discuss the potentiality of un-vampirizing. But this just sounds like a lot of work. Especially since I just want to get this game over. And so even if it would be a big quality of life increase to, you know, fix being a vampire, I don't think it's really worth it to me. Besides, it's got its benefits. You know, it just sucks not being able to do anything during the day. I thought there was beds there. You know, not being able to function during the day when you're full vampire is kind of shitty, but I lived through it. Watch, I'm gonna wake up from this and be all, oh, you have full vampirism. Suck it! I don't care about that. How about, here, sure, how about that? Since my blades is pathetically horrible. You've been causes a tickle on your face, but as you go to brush it off, you cannot move your arms. Looking at your skin, you realize that it has turned you to a brittle green glass. Standing perfectly still, you breathe in the shallow gulps of air. Knowing that moving will cause your skin to shatter into thousands of pieces, a tickle on your face worsens, and you know that you are about to sneeze. As your skin shatters, you wake up sweating. Yay. Just what I wanted was full vampirism right now. Where is Martin? Is this Martin?
With all due respect, Sayier, there must be another way. The risk is too great.
He's gonna die.
I know
oh,
the risk.
Oh, shit. I mean, he's not going to die, I swear.
The Countess will never agree to it.
She will. She must.
Very well. The blades are, as always, at your disposal.
Ah, here you are. Mm. I have good news. Sort.
Yes, let's see what he thinks of your plan.
Okay, well, if he's going to, you know, if this is turning into something major, like, hey, we're going to go off into battle right now, I kind of want to unvampirize before I go into this. So if all these people can just be asleep.
Hail.
That is not quite all. In fact, that's like essentially none.
Sup?
Sir.
Okay, as soon as. Okay, I cannot see. Well, screw it, I'm not seen right now. Thanks, buddy. Yep, and nobody saw me. Okay, good. Now we can go back and talk to him.
Sup?
You're back, and you've got the Great Stone.
Indeed I do, I'm pretty cool.
Yes, you did. I can't force you to do anything. I understand that. And I thank you.
Okay, here you go, buddy.
I never thought to see a Great Welkin Stone. As beautiful as all the old tales tell. But of course, its beauty is a mask for its deadly power, like everything crafted by the aliens.
Those dirty, dirty
now,
somethings?
We need only one more item, and we'll be ready to open a portal to Manka Cameron.
Does that mean we have two more quests left?
I should have seen it sooner. It's the counterpart to the Great Welkin Stone. just as the first two were the opposed powers of the Daedra and the Divines. Welkin stones contain the concentrated power of Mundus. Their counterparts are sigil stones.
Sigil stones, I've heard of those.
Open Oblivion gates. A great sigil stone, then, is what we require.
So I need to go into a great Oblivion gate.
You're not going to like it. Joffrey doesn't like it. The Countess of Bruma certainly isn't going to like it. Great sigil stones are the anchors of great gates. The kind of gate the mythic Dawn opened at Kvarch. The kind of gate the mythic Dawn wants to open here to destroy Bruma. I said you weren't going to like it.
Yeah.
The risk is great, I know. I was at Kvarch. I saw the terrible power of the Daedric siege engine. But we have no choice. The only way to recover the Amulet of Kings is to allow the Mythic Dawn to proceed with their plan to attack Bruma.
Yay. This sounds great.
No. I'll lead the defense of Bruma myself.
That sounds like a horrible plan.
If I am to be Emperor, it's time I started acting like one.
Do the Emperors typically go in and to battle like that?
Remember when we first met in Kvarch? I told you that I didn't want any part of the gods' plan. I still don't know if there is a divine plan, but I've come to realize that it doesn't matter. What matters is that we act, that we do what's right when confronted with evil.
And if you die and we can't light the torches again?
That's what you did at Kvarch. It wasn't the gods that saved us, it was you. Were you acting for the gods? I don't know.
Probably.
But now, it's my turn to act.
Okay.
Please, my friend, I need your judgment, not your obedience. I explain myself to you so you understand me, and so you can explain to the Countess.
Hey! Don't put me right in the middle of this.
I'm afraid she may take a bit more convincing than you.
I don't believe... Oh, fuck.
Good. Have her meet me in the Chapel of Talos for a council of war. That seems a fitting place to make such desperate plans.
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lordy, Lordy. So I taught them how to shut the Oblivion gates just so that they can just open one. Yeah. Great plans. Great plans all around. Let's go buy some arrows. Loading, loading. Load that loading, load. What the hell are you guys running off for? Hey! What are you doing? New arrows. Free arrows, in fact. Huh! Well. That was interesting, to say the very least. Oh yeah, because I led vampires out of the tunnels, didn't I, when I just ran by. Heh. Weird. Whatever. Okay, a couple hours to let the stores open up. Isn't this the store I popped out of when I was coming out, too? Maybe it wasn't. Maybe I'm confusing that. Sup?
Welcome to a... What can I interest you in?
Those.
Yeah, sure. You're a fine negotiator.
Those. Yep.
You bought that for us.
Oops, I meant to buy them all.
A bargain at any price.
Oh, I guess it just can't sell out of those. Something like that? Okay, whatever. I won't question it. Eight damage. It doesn't seem like that much more, honestly. Okay. We're gonna have to do some convincing on here. My convincing is pretty much, this town's already shit, so what's the worst that can happen? It getting wiped off the map? Oh, that probably overall save the world, potentially. Who is here already talking to her?
I heard that you helped the guard close that Oblivion gate. Thanks. We were getting
you
worried
were
about
there
that damn
with
thing.
Me. What are you talking about? You heard.
Just go.
Hey, don't be angry about me.